Welcome to Dr. P.C. Verma Economics YouTube class. In this class, we discuss topics related to UPSC examination, IAS, IFS, Indian Economic Service, and RBI, Officers Grade Examination, the State Bank of India interview. In all these, we find the importance of agriculture because our country is based upon agriculture. And so, what are the principles of agricultural sustainability? Old method of agricultural cultivation is now required to be changed with the new technique. And seeing the future of food requirement for 142 crore population of our country, and changing scenario, that is climate change and its effect upon agriculture production, all these are talked about. And Mr. Dr. Manish Mann, expert in agricultural intensification and agroforestry, has pointed out principles of agricultural sustainability, which we are going to discuss. And you must be aware of the fact that written test is only the second gate. Third gate is interview. And for interview, you must have in knowledge in a on different aspects of the economy, and you must not cheat in the interview. If you don't know, say no, I don't. There should not be any hit and run. Such type of things is not allowed interview. And I'm Dr. P.C. Verma, economist. I'm teaching economics for the last 50 years. I worked as University Professor of Economics, Department of Economics, Patna College, Patna University. I have taught as a guest faculty in Chanakya National Law University, Patna, BIT Mesra, Patna campus, and in Patna University itself, other departments such as Postgraduate Department of Sociology, Patna Science College, everywhere I taught economics. You will be surprised to know that I am being an arts professor. How can I teach in science college? In science college, there is a course, PGDAS, Postgraduate Diploma in Actuarial Science. Postgraduate Diploma in Actuarial Science means, actuarial means risk, and risk is a factor of economics. So many models which we taught in economics, that is part of actuarial economics. So I was a guest faculty teacher in Science College, Patna Science College. I taught in the postgraduate department of sociology, which is known as postgraduate in master's in social welfare, MSW. That MSW is very, very important nowadays for the appointment of welfare officers. So that is being read after graduation, master's in MSW, master's in social welfare. I taught there capitalism versus socialism. You all know book of Milton Friedman, Capitalism and Socialism. Very important book. You must go through it. I taught law economics in Chanakanasa Law University. And from there, I visited Poland, Germany, and Netherlands. We all know that International Court of Justice in Netherlands. So I was with 25 students and Vice Chancellor and a star of Chanakanasa Law University, visited Netherlands, International Court of Justice for the law students. And there were short course discussions in Poland University and in Germany, and then thereafter Netherlands. So education has a great scope if you develop yourself with the change in time, change in technique, change in variables. And what I did, I topped in the university gold medal. I received a master's degree in economics in Bihar University, Muzaffarpur. But thereafter, I topped in Ranchi University selections of lecturer, and I joined as a lecturer in Ranchi University, Tata College, Chaibasa. There I worked few months. Thereafter, I get opportunity to appear in Bihar Public Service Commission for the appointment of lecturer in Patna University. You will be glad to know that I again topped in the list of lecturers selected under Patna University, and I was the number one nominee of the BPSC, and I joined Patna College. There I worked throughout as a lecturer, as an assistant, associate professor, as a university professor, and finally I retired from there. But my convention is that teacher never retire. After retiring from the university professor, Patna University, I established in Delhi, Mukherjee Nagar, Ansel Building near Vatra Cinema, Dr. P.C. Verma Economics Academy, and one office near the Raj Coaching, Rajendar Nagar, Khan Coaching, Rajendar Nagar, just third building, Dr. P.C. Verma Economics Academy. English medium in Rajendar Nagar, Hindi medium Mukherjee Nagar. But during COVID, I shifted to this online teaching, and thereafter I'm continuing it, and I find more interest in it because it is all India, and you may say other, some students of Pakistan, some students of Nepal, some students of Canada, some students of other countries visited my site, Dr. P.C. Verma Economist YouTube channel. So, what I want to impress upon you, that learning by doing is a method developed by Nobel Prize winner economist. And learning by doing tell us that always try to learn and then you do it in a practice. Let us examine views of Dr. Manish Mann, expert in agricultural intensification and agroforestry, as the principles of agriculture sustainability. There are many principles. Of there are many principles of agricultural sustainability. There are many principles of agricultural sustainability. Richard. Below. Sustainable agriculture is a system of farming that focuses on meeting the current production demand without compromising on the ability of future generations to meet their needs. Sustainable agriculture is a system of farming. System of farming that focuses on meeting the current production. Current production demands without compromising without compromising on the ability of future generation. Future generation, future generations to meet their needs. It takes into account the aspects related to ecology, ecological stability. Economic viability. Economic viability. Economic viability and socio-cultural continuity. Socio-cultural continuity while preserving natural resources. for future generation. For future generations. Principles of sustainable agriculture are shown below. Number one, increasing productivity. Number two, protecting and enhancing and enhancing natural resources. Natural resources. Improving livelihoods forestry. Livelihood and fostering inclusive economic growth and fostering inclusive economic growth. Number four. Enhancing. The resilience. Enhancing the resilience of people. Communities. An ecosystem. Ecosystems. Adapting. Governance. To new. New challenges. Increasing productivity. The transition from conventional farming. Farming to happens. Against the backdrop of growing concerns over changing climate pattern environmental sustainability. Sustainability and a steadily expanding population. Consistently increasing agricultural productivity agricultural productivity is crucial to maintaining food security. Food security. This must also focus This must also focus focus. Reducing the dependence on chemical fertilizer. On chemical fertilizer and pesticide. Pesticides, the very concept The very concept of efficiency The very concept of efficiency needs to evolve where efficient where efficient production Efficient production must include must Must include water and energy. Energy, a smart the smart production systems in addition to In addition to in addition to higher yields, reducing the agricultural footprint. Reducing the agricultural footprint while ensuring food security. While ensuring food security is one of the key attributes of sustainable agriculture, of sustainable agriculture. Number two, protecting and enhancing natural resources. Sustainable agriculture growth requires conservation requires conservation and sustainable use and sustainable use of scarce natural resources. Natural resources like soil and water, Agricultural production depends agricultural. Production, agriculture production depends directly on natural resources. On natural sources, and therefore the sustainability of production of production depends on the sustainability of the resources themselves. Indian agriculture remains dominant remains predominantly rain-fed, covering about 60%. percent of the country's net. Net sown area. And accounts. And accounts for 40%. Of the total food production. Of the total food production. In such a scenario, sustainable agriculture sustainable agriculture focuses on maintaining and enhancing while fertility optimally managing optimally managing water resources. and reducing. Water pollution, water pollution, and developing wage. Developing developing ways to reduce the emission of greenhouse. Greenhouse gases. Adequate access adequate access to resources. Can significantly reduce poverty. and food. Insecurity. Food insecurity in rural areas. Rural areas. Agriculture is one of the most labor intensive of all. Of all economic activities, therefore. Therefore, there exist a direct correlation, a direct correlation between increased agricultural income increased increased agricultural incomes. Increased agriculture incomes and reduced poverty. Agricultural sustainability Agricultural sustainability can only be achieved if it provides decent employment condition, decent employment conditions.